Azure Event Meetings. Today we have with us Paul Machuku. Paul Machuku will be talking us through with Azure Backups. He's new to with presentation in our community. So Paul, it's a pleasure to have you here. And yeah, the floor is yours. Stop sharing.
Yeah, thank you very much, Shugo. Thank you very much for the introduction. Today I'll be taking everyone on administer data protection. It's a topic in Azure Backup. So to start, we'll look at one of our first lessons, which will talk about how to configure file and folder backups. There, under this lesson, we're going to talk about we're going to describe Azure benefits, implement Azure Backup Center, set up recovery service vault backup options. Then we're going to have a lab session to demonstrate how to go about the Azure file share, how to back it up. Majorly, we're going to be looking at three labs. We're going to look at backing up an Azure file share. We're going to look at backing up on-premises files on folder. We're also going to look at how to use the Microsoft Azure Recovery Service Services Agent, which is MAS to be precise. Due to the time constraints, we might not be able to go further to look at MAPS, MAB, Microsoft Azure Backup Server. We might not be able to look at that today. Probably some other time we would have time to look at that. Then we're going to do a demonstration, which is also lab, to show us how to go about that. So let's start with to describe Azure Backup benefits. From the slide, you can see that Azure-based services is an Azure-based services used to back up and restore data in Microsoft Cloud. That's part of the benefits. Another is it has an automatic storage management. It has multiple storage options. In these multiple storage options, there are two types of it. One of them is it gives you locally redundant storage, which is LRS, which replicates your data three times. And all copies of that data will exist within the same region. That's what differentiates it from the second type, which is the dual redundant storage. The GRS. So the GRS replicates your data to a secondary region hundreds of miles away from the primary location of the source data. So we'll look at next, we're going to look at during the labs, we're going to look at what application consistent backup is all about. We're also going to look at one of the benefits, which is long-term retention. Long-term retention is the factor you can have the backups as long as you want, more than 90 days. You know, you can back it up for 365 days. You know, that's a year, and all that capabilities. So basically, the application consistent backup you see there. We're going to look at what it means. So basically, when application consistent backup refers to is referring to the restore point. So it means the recovery point has all the required data to restore the backup, because for an application server, for example, when you've started your backup, before the backup Azure services, the backup take place, it's actually going to wait for every, it's going to wait for every services to have completed any unfinished transaction. Is going to wait for that to complete before the backups take place. Then the backup becomes application consistent. Unlike the crash consistent backup, once you hit the backup, it doesn't matter if it's completed or not. It's just going to go ahead and start the backup job. And that's exactly from that point in which the backup has been initiated, probably depending on the policy you have set up. So then the backup becomes crash consistent. We're going to look at that while we're doing the labs. Probably we'll create a VM and then we'll take a look at how the outcome would be. So next, we're going to be looking at implement Azure Backup Center. So basically what this is the Backup Center provides a unified management experience in Azure. This unified management experience in Azure, whereby you can, you know, from a glance, basically from a glance, you can manage, you can monitor, that's govern, of course. You can govern, you can monitor, you can operate, and you can analyze backups at a scale. From this picture here, you can see, don't worry, I'm going to take you all to my lab environment first, just to take a look at this properly. So it's a data source centric management focused on what you're backing up, connected experience with native integrations that enable management at a scale. So what this basically does is, maybe you can have more than one or two or three recovery service vaults, for example. From this center, from this backup center, you're able to view all of them at a glance, rather than, you know, going into the recovery service vaults one by one. Don't worry, you might ask what is a recovery service vault. During the course of this, I'm going to get to that and explain exactly what a recovery service vault is. So So we're going to, as I made mention of, we're going to be setting up a recovery service vault. So you might ask what a recovery service vault is. A recovery service vault, basically, it stores backup data for various Azure services, such as LAAS VMs. That's infrastructure as a service VMs, which could either be a Linux or a Windows, and then Azure SQL database. So a recovery service vault makes it easy to organize your backup data while minimizing management overhead. That's what a recovery service vault is. I'm going to also have a lab where we create that, and it's basically what we're going to use throughout the entire course, throughout the entire labs, because each of your backups, your backup jobs actually occurs in a recovery service vault. For it to be able to have a backup, you have to have a vault where these backups are being saved. So we're going to look at that too. Yeah, so the first demonstration we're going to be having would be to backup an Azure file share. So hang on while I move us over to the lab for us to take a look at how we can go about this. So this is my lab right now. How did I get here? I'm just going to open a new tab. I'm going to close this, and I'm going to go to portal.azure.com. And this is going to open. Okay. So we want to create, we want to back up an Azure file share. And for you to be able to back up an Azure file share, first of all, you have to have a storage account, because an Azure file share is hosted, it's in a storage account. So for us to achieve this, we're going to need to, first of all, have to create a storage account. But before I go ahead to do that, I'm going to show us the single pane of glass. That's the backup center, which I spoke of earlier. So I have it here already, but just in case in your lab you don't see it here, you could just go ahead and type backup or back, and then you see the backup center. So this is it. As you can see, it's a single pane of glass. You ain't seen anything right here right now, because I obviously do not have any backup right now, which I have in the past, which is either in progress or that has completed or failed, because I have no backup currently at all in my infrastructure, that's in my Azure. That's why this is empty. But look at some of the things you can do here. You can actually even create a backup from here. You can restore from here. You can go ahead to create a policy, and then you can even go ahead to create a recovery service vault, which I spoke of earlier. You can go ahead to create that from here. But for the purpose of this course, I'm not going to be creating a recovery service vault from this site. I'll be creating it standalone, like separately. Basically, you use here to monitor your backups, and you can actually govern and, you know, create monitor backup jobs, also alerts, metrics, get reports. I made mention of policies, create backup policies also, and ensure backup compliance. So let's go ahead to create a recovery service vault, and then we'll go ahead to create a storage account. So first of all, you can type recovery, then this recovery service vault. Yes, it's empty. I have nothing here. You can go ahead to click on create recovery service vault over here or right here. Create. I'm going to be using my Visual Studio Enterprise subscription. For those of you that have no idea about what a subscription is about, depending on the survey for this course, if I get enough likes or feedback, I can do a course concerning that separately. But subscription as a topic is not covered under this course. Basically, I have two subscriptions. I have, for my personal lab, I have my MSDN platform subscription and Visual Studio Enterprise subscription. I can decide to use this one. Basically, without the subscription, you cannot create resources. And these subscriptions come with a value, with the money. There's pay as you go. And though the type I have right now has a particular amount of money in it, I have that of $150 and I have that of $100. I'll be going ahead with my Visual Studio subscription. So very important, you have to have a resource group. You can create a resource group separately, but this gives us a platform to create it from here. I'm going to name this AZ. I'm going to name it AZ104RG resource group. I've created a resource group. My vault, I'm going to name it AZ104 vault. Let me leave it at V. AZ104V. These are various regions. There are a lot of regions in which you can select. But I'm going to leave mine at East US. I don't really care much about tag. Mostly I use tag whenever I'm trying to associate with billing, you know, to maybe classify. It's not really that important unless you want to properly arrange your resources. But for the purpose of this lab, it's not really necessary. So I'm just going to go ahead to review and then create. So this is going to take just a little while this is trying to start, so that I'll be able to utilize the little time I have. I will just go ahead and start creating a storage account. Same way, create. Start with create. I believe I chose, before that, just to be sure. Deployment progress under Visual Studio subscription. So I'm going to go ahead to create under the same subscription also. Resource group, I don't want to go ahead to create a new resource group. I already have the one I created. It was automatically selected over here. So usually when creating a storage account, it requires most time. It requires a unique name. Let's see if that applies now. AZ104. Yeah, it requires a unique name. See, it says the storage name has been taken. So test. Okay, I'm just going to add a random digit just to accept this on time. Yeah, this hasn't been taken. So I'm just going ahead to choose local redundant. In case you don't know what that is all about, it says lowest cost option with basic protection against server rack and drive failures. Recommended for non-critical scenario. Yeah, this is a non-critical scenario. It's a lab, unlike the Joule redundant. So this topic is covered under Azure Storage. I could have a different class, separate class concerning this, because if I should go ahead to explain what this is all about, it might eat up my remaining time. So I'm going to go ahead to click on local, and then I'm just going to go ahead to review and then create. Let's see. Yeah, I can go ahead to create. If there was any requirements which I didn't do, I was going to get a warning in that page, and it was going to direct me to any mistakes I have made. So seems no mistakes, no problems. Yeah, so my recovery service vault is complete according to this. I can go ahead to go to resource. This is my recovery service vault. Just in case, I'm going to go back to home and click on recovery service vault. So this is my recovery service vault I created. It's ready. And also now, yeah, my storage account is also ready now. This is it. But just in case, I'll go back, click on storage account. Storage account, refresh. It's supposed to be here. Let's see. Home. Yeah, here you are. Storage account, it's here. So I'm going to click on this. And since we're trying to back up an Azure file share, I would have to create a file share. Click on file share. I'm going to name this file share AZ104. Let me name it AZ104 file share. AZ104 file share. And I'm just going to go ahead to create. So after creating this file share, now I need to go ahead to upload the document into this file share. So I'm going to click on this. Into the AZ104 file share. Now I'm going to upload. Click on upload. Come to this folder symbol. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead with this document and upload it. So let's upload. Yeah, so it's complete. The upload is complete. And now that it's complete, I can then go ahead to my resource recovery service vault, and then go ahead to back up the storage account. That's the file share itself. So this is my AZ104 recovery service vault, and then I'm going into it. Next, I'm going to go into backup. It's either you backup through here, but before that, let me just go ahead to see what this does. First of all, activity log. We are in the overview page. This is where you can get logs concerning the activities done here. What else is important? This is where you can create your backup job from here. This is where you can create your replication. Your replication can be done from here. This is where you can check out or go into the backup jobs you have created. This is where you can check up the replicated. Maybe you want to go to any of the replications you've started, initiated. And if you want to monitor a backup or a replication, you can do that from over here, backup jobs. This is where you monitor your backup jobs from. And this is where you monitor your replication jobs from. And then this is where you create your backup policy. You know what? Let's go ahead. Let's create a backup policy first before we go ahead to backup the file share. So backup policy. These are the default ones already created in Azure. And then I'm going to click on add. So I'm going to select Azure file share over here. I'm going to name this AZ104 file. Yeah, let me name it file share policy. Is it 104 file share policy? Okay, accepted. So this is where you create your backup policy. Like as I said, mentioned, it's for Azure file share. So here you can decide the frequency of the policy. That's the backup, the policy, backup policy you're creating. Do you want it to be daily? You want it to be hourly? I think I'll prefer daily. And what time? You know, to create these things, there has to be an organizational policy you're following in your environments, in your company, wherever you work. So usually I think most guys, most companies, I think they do their backups probably in the night or whenever no much user activities. Most times that's when they take the backup, but not all. I said some. For the purpose of this lab, I'm going to leave it at this 8 a.m. But see, you can go ahead to change this if you're not probably okay with this. You can change the time zone also, the various time zones. You can change to anyone you'd want. And then retention range for the backup policy you're creating. You can go ahead. By default, the daily one is selected for 8 a.m. as we specified here. And it's going to be retained for 30 days. I can change this to 60 days if I want. I can change this to whatever I want, but I think I'm just going to leave it at the default 30. If I want, I can go ahead to configure also for weekly retention. If I want, I could make for the weekly. I want it to be I want the backup to also be retained on for Sundays and Mondays and Tuesdays if I want, maybe only Monday if I want, you know, that's the retention of the backup point. If I want it to be this way, I could check this box, then configure that. I could do for monthly, I could do for yearly, however I want, but I'm just going to stick to the defaults and go ahead to create a file share, create a policy, a file share policy for our backup job we're about to create. So we just wait a bit for this to complete and we proceed. Yeah, so it's done. Go to resource and I'll just show us the policy we created underneath backup policies. This is the policy we just created. And don't worry, we'll get to see where standard and enhanced comes into play. It's not available for the file share and backup policy. We'll get to see that later on during this course. So I'll be moving on to backups. Let's go ahead to create a backup job. Where's your workload running? Definitely in Azure. So we're going to select Azure File Share. We're going to click on backup. But before that, I wanted to use this opportunity to show you guys that you have the opportunity to choose Azure, Azure Stack Hub. Most importantly, you can actually back up on premises also. And these are the things you can back up from on premises: files and folders, Hyper-V, virtual machines on your on premises, VMware also. That's VMs in VMware, Microsoft SQL Server, SharePoint, Exchange, System States, Bare Metal Recovery. These are the things you can back up from your on premises infrastructure, actually. So, I just had to show you that. Then for Azure, these are the things you can back up from Azure. SQL Server in Azure VM, SAP, HANA or SAP, H-A-N-A in Azure VM. We're trying to back up an Azure file share. So I'm going to go ahead to click on backup. And then the storage account. Remember we created a storage account earlier. So I'm going to go ahead to select, so we can locate that storage account we created. Let's see. So let's configure backup. We can't add yet. Let's see why. Yeah, here you are. This is it. So this is the storage account we created. And I'm going to go ahead to register it. So we're going to register this. So Azure's registration is part of what makes up the backup infrastructure. So register this. Let's wait while that registers. So it's going to take a little while. Yeah, as you can see, it still says registering storage account with recovery service vault. And now that is complete. So now we've registered the storage account we're trying to back up. We can then go ahead to add the file share. So we'll go ahead to select the particular file share that we created after creating the storage account, which is this. Then click on OK. Then see, automatically the policy we created was selected. But if we had a different policy we would like to select, we could go ahead to select them over here. I did not create a different policy aside this, so this is what's available for the file share because it was what I created, right? But I could also go ahead to create a policy from here too. I can go ahead to create a new policy if I wanted. I could do that from here too. And based on what's written in this policy is what you're seeing here. We did not configure weekly. We did not configure yearly. So this what is in this policy. So we can go ahead to enable backup. Go ahead to enable the backup. And then we wait till that concludes. Yeah. So for now, let's continue with the course. So, and let's see. Next thing we're going to look at would be configure on-premises file and folder backup. Okay. To do that, obviously, we already looked at the recovery service vaults, which is what we have next to discuss. We already discussed about recovery service vault and some of the things it can do. So what this diagram over here is just trying to explain is the process. The process involved in creating, in configuring on-premises file and folder backup. That's what this is just talking about. So the first step would be to, I don't know, are you guys hearing me? Just to be sure, yeah. So first step would be to create the recovery service vault. Second step would be to download the agents. And next step would be to download the credential file. Yeah, they were joined together over here, which is download agents and credential file. And the third step would be to install and register the agents. And final step would be to configure the backup. So let's see. Then once that is complete, this is how the agent looks like. And the backup jobs being done in the agents, this is how they look like. So backup or recovery file and folder on physical or virtual Windows OS. VMs can be on-premises or in Azure. It doesn't matter where the VM is. It can be in on-premises or in Azure. So what I'm going to do is for the labs, I'm going to back up my personal system. That's this system I'm using to have this class right now. That's what I'm going to back up. And then no separate backups. Server required, not application aware. Yeah, this is part of the deficits or disadvantages of using these services. Earlier, I made mention of there's the MARS service and there's the MAPS service. So MARS, like M-A-R-S, Microsoft Azure Recovery Service agent. So the MARS agent is not application aware. If you want something that is application aware, specialized, then you would have to use the MAPS, M-A-B-S, Microsoft Azure Backup Server. That's what you have to use. Fortunately, this also does not have, does not support Linux based systems also. So I'm going to have this demonstration right now. I'm going to have a demonstration and let's move over to the labs. Okay, so to move over to the lab. Yeah, so going to the lab right now, once again, I'm going to go to home. From home right now, I'm going to go to, since we're trying to back up an on-premises file and folder, we'll go to recovery service vaults once again. As I made mention of, that's where all the backups are usually done in the recovery service vaults. So for your environment, you can decide to create the various recovery service vaults based on the locations that you have or you use. Like this recovery service vault I built right now, it's for East US. So we'll go ahead right now and then create a new one. We'll go ahead right now and then start to create a new backup job. So click on backup once again. Where's your workload running? We're going to select on-premises this time around. And drop down, we're going to select files and folder. Then we'll go ahead to prepare infrastructure. So To prepare the infrastructure, first of all, you need to download the agent for Windows Server or Windows Clients. You click on this, so it's going to download the agent installer. It's going to download the agent installer. And I'm going to open the installer right now and share that with us. So to share that with us right now. Okay, so just to be sure we all can see that. That's the installer. Yeah, so this is the installer. So next we're going to click on so this is just the installation folder that will be created for this purpose. The cache location, all this will be created in your C drive. I want to leave this at default. Click on next. Click on next. I already have these available. I'm going to click on install. Let's click on install. So once these completes, I'm going to then have to download another file. So next thing is to proceed to registration. Proceed to registration. This is the place. So we need this credential, right? But to be able to get this credential, we'll go back to the portal, and that's where we're going to get that from. So going back to Azure itself, we're going to check this box to say we've already downloaded it. And then next, we click on download. So this is going to download. And this is what we're going to upload over there. Exactly what we're going to be uploading. So here, we for the vault identification, we're going to click on browse. And we're going to go to the exact location, which is this. This is what we just downloaded right now. Click on open. That's validated. Click on next. So you can go ahead to type in passwords, which is which you prefer. That's the passphrase. You can go ahead to type in the passphrase you prefer. Type it up and down, but I'm just going to go ahead to generate it. Generate it for me. And then this is just telling you to save this passphrase at a particular location. I'm going to save it in my desktop for the purpose of this lab, this course. In the real environment, a working environment, it's not advisable. You save your password in your desktop. So click on OK. Yeah, it's warning us over here due to where we're saving our passphrase. So I'll just go ahead to click on yes to continue. And yes to continue, and just give it a little time. So yes, this is complete. we can go ahead to close, and now let's go into the interface, the agent interface. So Microsoft. Go into the interface. So this is it. Yeah. So this is the MAS, how it looks like. As I made mention of, I installed it in my system, which I'm using to teach right now. Obviously, because this is a lab. So I'm trying to back up my system, the files and folders in my system. So what I'll be doing now is we have to schedule. First of all, let's take a look at some of the options. If you go to change properties, it gives you the interface where you can then go ahead to change your passphrase, the one we set initially. You can go ahead to change that and put a new one and select a new location. If you're using a proxy configuration, you can use that over here if you have that, but now I don't have anything like that. So I think, yeah, basically, yeah, go ahead to close this. And next thing we would want to do is to, the server is registered already. Remember, that's what we did initially. So what we can do next is to schedule backup. We need to schedule backup because we haven't told it what to do. We haven't said when it's backing up and all that. So get started. Next, we're going to click on add item. This is my C drive. So I click on the drop down. There's a various things there. I can decide to back up. Yeah, let me back up AZ copy. I'm going to back up this folder. Just this folder. Selecting what I want to back up. I'm going to click on OK. I don't want to exclude anything, so I'm good with that. Click on Next. So do I want a daily backup or a weekly backup? That's where I get the option. So every week, if I'm going with that, is it 4 weeks, every 2 weeks, 3 weeks, you know, every 1 week on Sunday, or every 1 week on Monday, or on Monday and Friday, you know. I'm going to choose day, and I'm going to leave it at default 11 p.m. So for the day, it allows you to be able to configure three different backup intervals. So in a day, if I want to have three different backups or three separate backups, I can do that, select a different time, do that, select a different time. But I wouldn't want that. I don't want that. So I'm going to go ahead to select none because this is 12 a.m. 00. So none. I just want one a day. So for the daily backup, after that, configuring that, I can still go ahead over here to, you know, enable weekly backup for here. Retain backup, that's my retention for the daily backup. Retention period for the daily backup. I could, if I want, I could make it on Saturdays, or change it to Tuesdays, or make it Mondays and Tuesdays. You get the picture. As you want, you can select the time you want the backup to be happening and how long you want it to be retained for. For 104 days, reduce it or increase it as much as you want. That's what we talked about in the beginning of the course when we said it has long retention periods. So you can increase it as much as you want. So for the purpose of this, I wouldn't want a monthly and a yearly. I'll leave it at a weekly. Click on next. Yes, I want it online. Next. And then finish. So with this, I have scheduled backup close. I've scheduled the backup. So having scheduled the backup is going to start at exactly this time, 23:00, which is 11, which is 11 p.m. So, but I can go ahead to backup now. Same principles, just backup. It says you may close the wizard, so I can decide to close this if I wanted. So this is taking a snapshot of my file and folder, exactly the part I want to back up. Preparing storage, as you can see. So we'll give it a little time. Okay, why this is going on. We can go ahead to just take a look at the Azure portal and then come back to this. Yeah, so in the Azure portal, take a look at this. We can go back to the vault. Come back to backup items. Is it going to be there yet? Yes, because the backup agent was installed. That's why you're seeing this there. And this is my system. Yeah, with my system name. I don't trust most of you guys, so I'm going to have to change my system name after this. Then the backup is not over, so there's nothing really pretty much I can do from here. And the more like the source data, the source where the backup is actually happening from. If you notice, I scheduled the backup directly on my system, which is in this case acting like the server I'm trying to back up, which is on premises, right? So the backup, everything is being configured from my system. So I wouldn't have much options, you know, to click on these three dots and do much, because I did the backup directly from my system, because via the agent, which is an extension of this, it's an extension of the Azure portal. So I'm going to take us over there to the screen again, and you all are going to see that the backup has completed. So you're going to see that now the backup has completed. So one sec, share that screen. No, so yeah, I believe you should be able to see my screen now. Yeah, so as you can see, status now says successful, job completed, the backup job has completed. As at now, and what next? Backup job completed. It's scheduled, status is scheduled. And that is how you can do your backup using MAS agents. As I made mention before, if you have an application, a specialized application like Exchange server, SharePoint server, you can go ahead to use MAS, because I'm not MAS, MABS, M-A-B-S, because the M-A-B-S, the MABS also does things, can do things the MAS also do. Now we'll get to take a look at that and probably just, you know, compare also. So let's move on to the next thing. Let's move on to the next thing. Share my screen. So the next lesson would be to configure virtual machine. So we're going to look at a lot of things like to protect virtual machine data. So we're going to look at some snapshots, you know, backup virtual machines. I'll try to cover as much as this as possible due to the time constraints. I'll try my best as much as possible to cover these. I'll probably do soft deletes just for you to take a look at that. And yeah, so there are various scenarios you might want to, that might make you want to back up your virtual machines. Like, for example, your company has several critical virtual machine workloads running on Azure, and you want to be able to recover these machines if there is data loss or corruption. You just want to be able to recover them. So you can actually protect your data by taking backups at regular intervals. And there are various backup options available to VMs depending on your use case. And these are the various backup options which we are seeing here right now. For Azure Backup, you use it for backing up Azure VMs running production. That's VMs in Azure. And it supports application consistent backup. Earlier, I made mention of application consistent backup, the difference with crash consistent backup. I made mention of the difference between the application consistent backup and then the crash consistent backup. So for the application consistent backup, in case you missed that, the simple way you can explain this is that an application like Exchange has an activity it's supposed to carry out. For example, once you back it up, application consistent means every backup, every transaction, every workload meant to be done, completed before the backup started. It's going to be application consistent. But whenever the backup just occurs, irrespective of that, it just backs up because you enabled backup. It didn't wait for whatever process that's supposed to finish to finish. Then the backup becomes crash consistent. A very good example of crash consistent backup is when you're backing up a VM that is turned off. That's a virtual machine that is turned off. You're going to see it that it saves at a crash consistent backup. So there's a Azure Site Recovery. It's used majorly for to protect your VMs from major disaster scenarios. Maybe there's a tornado, or there's total blackouts like in the entire country, you know, various scenarios. And you want your users to be able to continue working. You know, there's these other sites where your data are being replicated to in an offsite, a different region, that it is not possible, that cannot be affected, you know. If you want it to be, if you want to have much more elasticity, if you want, because there can be possibilities whereby you have a replication at a different site, then your main site, maybe a disaster occurs, it's down, and your replicated site also gets down due to maybe generator failure or any reason. That's, you are down both sides. So most times, if your organization can afford it, you could try to have various zones, not just depending on one particular site for replication. You can try to have more than one site, you know, to mitigate things like that. So snapshots provide a quick and simple option for backing up VMs that use managed disks. Basically, that's what it is. It's mostly used in development and test environments because it provides quick and simple option for backing up VMs. With snapshots, you can manage disks at any point in time. For example, if you create a snapshot of a managed disks with provisioned capacity of maybe 60 gig, and the actual size in it is actually 10 gig, the snapshots, you'll be built for just the actual size, which is the 10 gig. You're not going to be built because your managed disk is 64 gig, so you're paying for the entire 64 gig. No, based on what is inside, the actual size, if it's 10 gig, that's what you're paying for, basically. So you need to know that. That's referring to still the snapshot. Yeah. So, an Azure backup consists of two phases. First of all, the virtual machine snapshot is taken. And secondly, the virtual machine snapshots is being transferred to the recovery service vaults. Basically, that's what all this diagram is trying to say. Use snapshots taken as part of backup job, reduce recovery wait time. Yeah, because snapshot is like immediately you click on it, it takes it and it tries to create that instance for you to restore from at any point in time. So, set up recovery service vault backup options for VMs. We're going to be looking at that pretty soon. So as I mentioned before, a recovery service vault is a storage entity in Azure that houses data. So data, which is the backup data. So over here in this diagram, what is being compared here is just the Azure workloads and then the on-premises workloads. Things you can do backup with the on-premises and things you can backup with the Azure. In Azure, which I just showed us, earlier, that there's a difference. I made mention of file share, which we've already demoed for. And for the on-premises one, we demoed for the files and folder. So, but don't worry right now, we're going to be demoing with virtual machines and to see how you can go about that. So backup virtual machines. So there are steps to do this. First of all, you have to create a recovery service vault, which we already did. And then we use the portal to define the backup. Here we can do things like snapshots of your data at defined intervals. This snapshot is stored in recovery services vault, which we mentioned earlier. And then for the backup, so for the backup to occur, if the VM was created with one of the VMs in the gallery of Azure, the agent will be there already, installed already automatically while you're provisioning the VM. If not, if it's a different VM, then you might have to install the agent separately. You might have to install the agent separately. Yeah, from this diagram to the right, you can see crash consistent. It's very likely that this virtual machine was turned off while the backup job occurred. Look at the various things you can do. You can stop the backup, you can restore, you can backup now, you can just recover a file. So let's see. Yeah, I made mention of the maps. Use it basically for specialized scenarios and specialized cases like the Exchange server, SharePoint, that's application. If you want the application consistent backup, for the agent, you use the maps. So we'll look at that also. But then, before we look at that, we would have to do a lab. A lab would demonstrate how to back up a virtual machine. But you should know that some of other benefits of the maps is that you have more flexibility and granular scheduling option for running backups. You can manage backups for multiple machines. That's multiple machines that you gather in protection groups in a single console. You can do that in a single console. For the maps, actually offers more flexibility, basically. It offers more flexibilities. There are way a lot of things you can do with the maps, unlike the MAS. I don't have any Exchange server right now or any SharePoint server right now I can use to demo this. Probably in our next meeting, I'll be able to do that. Yeah, because I'm also working with the 2 hours time frame I have. We'll look at, we'll just compare right now, compare between the MABS and MAS right now. So compare backup options. Let's look at that now. So, I made mention of the Azure Backup agent, which is the MAS, and I said Azure Backup Server, which is the MAPS, Go back, yeah. So the benefit of the MAS, which was the one we deployed, that's backing up my personal system, and the benefit is that the backup file and folder on physical or virtual window OS, you can do this. You can backup file and folder, which is what we did. There's no separate backup server required at all. Once you have the agent installed, you're good to go. While for the maps, it is app aware snapshots. So if you take a snapshot, it's going to make sure it captures all transactions that should have been completed before that takes place. It wouldn't just take a snapshot because you clicked on the snapshot button and then take up wherever the app has stopped or hasn't gotten to. It just takes a snapshot like that, which is crash persistent. So full flex for when to backups, recover, granularity, Linux support on Hyper-V and VMware VMs, backup and restore for VMware VMs. It doesn't require a system center license at all. So as you can see, the MABS has more options than the MAS. Then the limits from the demo, from the lab we did, I believe we had 3 days. In 3 days, we can set up our backups for just 3 days. We didn't see more than that. Yeah, so that's the limit. It is not application aware. The MABS is file folder and volume level restore only. That's the only thing you can restore. No support for Linux. So the MAS doesn't support Linux, but the MABS supports Linux. But the MABS has its own bad side or limits. One of them is cannot backup Oracle workloads. Always require live Azure subscription. No support for tape backup. So for the protection for the MAS, as you can see, files and folders, which is what we did. Backup, it has to be in a recovery service vault. Over here in the MABS, it can be in a locally attached disk or recovery service vault. And you can see it protects not just files and folders, it protects volumes, VMs, applications, where I make applications like the Exchange server, SharePoint server, you know, basically applications. I'm just using Exchange and SharePoint because they're well popular, what most organizations use, right? And workloads. So there's not really much to say here. What I can tell you that whenever you delete a VM, for example, the data is usually being backed up for an additional 14 days before it's. So when you delete, you soft delete, and then it stays for 14 additional days before it's totally been deleted. So you can, during this period, you can actually click on a single button on delete operation. Let me see if I can show you what I'm talking about. I think I can use here. No, it's not here. It's not here. I thought I would see it here. Yeah. So it is natively built in for all the recovery service vaults. So it's default. Once you delete, it's soft deletes and stays for an additional 14 days before it then finally gets deleted. So next, we're going to talk about Azure Site Recovery. We're going to talk about Azure Site Recovery, but before we do that, I think it'd be nice we go and demo for the backing up of VM. Then we get back here for the final topic and we try to round up. Yeah, it looks short, but it would require, it takes some time because of the VM deployments and all that. So I'll be sharing my screen right now. Okay. So what I'm going to do right now is we're going to take a break and we'll be back in 1:30. We're going to take a little break and we're back in 1:30. So bye okay, for now.
Perfect. Yeah, see you.
Thanks. Okay, guys, it's
Okay, welcome back, Paul.
Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah. Very much. So we would now proceed from here. We stopped around where we wanted to have a lab. So I'll be sharing my screen for us to proceed with that. So for us to go ahead to back up that, we would have to have, for us to go ahead to back up a virtual machine, we need to have a virtual machine, right? So we're going to go ahead to first of all create a virtual machine. Go to virtual machine. In case you didn't get that, you can, in case you don't see that in your Azure portal. Yeah, just in case, you can actually get a free Azure credits to be able to practice all what I'm doing right now. You can actually get that for free. But first of all, you will need to let me see if I can get us the link. Yeah, to get that, just start a free one. I'll be sharing that on the chat just in case. Sharing that on the chat to create a free Azure subscription so you can follow up with what I'm doing. So, yeah, so you can search for virtual machine over here, virtual machines. As you can see, there's no virtual machine for me. I can go ahead to create a virtual machine, a new one. Then I'm going to select my Visual Studio Enterprise subscription, which is exactly the subscription I used to create my recovery service vault. Select the resource group also. I don't want it to be this Ubuntu server. I want it to be Windows server. Any of these images, I'll just go ahead with 2019, and I'm going to name it AZ 104 VM East US availability zone. Because this is a lab, I'm going to put none required. Leave everything at default, but I have to give it a username and a password. So my password is anything you think of. So as I said, that thing you're thinking of, that's my password. And then I can go ahead to check this box. I'll check this box to reduce costs, right? If I have a license already, so that I can enjoy Azure hybrid benefits, but I'll just go ahead to create. Don't worry, if we're talking about virtual machines next time, I would go ahead to explain all these in details. So validation, something is missing. I didn't fill out something, obviously. So this will point me to the right side. What did I miss out? Azure admin. Let's see, I didn't see that error very well. I definitely missed out something, probably. Okay, seems I didn't miss anything for some reasons. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead to create. So we're going to give this a little time for this to start complete. So various resources will be created when creating a virtual machine. Various resources are required. The virtual network, you know, That's the VNet, the IP, the network security group, the allow and the block, you know, and all that. So you can check the operation details, check to see details if you want. Like the duration, 7 seconds. Took 7 seconds for this to complete. So deployment is still in progress, and now it's going to, it's creating the, this is in progress actually. Complete is green mark. So we'll just give it a little time and it will be complete. Yeah, so it's complete now. So you can go ahead to go to resource. This is graded out starts, means the VM has started already. So I have created a VM. I don't want to do anything here. I don't want to log in. I just want to back this up, right? So back to my recovery service vault, go to AZ104, AZ104V. That's the name of my resource group. Click on backup. Underneath backup, virtual machine, yes. Back this up. I didn't create any policy for this, but I can go ahead to create here. So I made mention of the standard and enhanced. That's for the policy subtype. So they're actually different. Just it has to do with, it adds to your costing anyways. They are different. See, take a look. If you select the standard once a day option for backup, the enhanced has multiple backups per day. 1 to 5 days operational tire. This has 1 to 30 days. They both have vault tire, but the enhanced has zone redundancy, resilient snapshots tire, support for trusted Azure VM. The standard doesn't have that. So for the purpose of this, I'm just going to leave it at the default, which is the standard. I don't want to create a new policy. I already went through how to create a backup policy. So I'm going to leave it at the default policy, which has all this, but I'm going to go ahead and select the VM which I want to back up. So let's see. Says no VM yet. I'm just going to patience, refresh this page, and let's see if I'm going to see a VM. Yeah, here it is, the VM. Click on OK to add it. So here it is. If I want to back up only the DIX only, no, I want to back up the entire VM. So I'm not going to check that. So here's the thing, you can add as much as you want. If I had created up to 5 virtual machines that I want to back up at the same time, I can go ahead to click on add and add the remaining ones listed. Definitely it will be listed here, but I have only one VM. So I'm going to just enable backup. So it also waits till this completes. You can also see details over here, as I mentioned earlier. Okay, I might have to speed up a bit because of the time so that I can see if I can cover as much as possible. Okay. So we don't necessarily need to wait here till the VM finishes to provision. We can go ahead to our recovery service vault. Oops, that shouldn't have shown. Recovery service vault, and yeah, as you can see, the VM is the backup is complete. Not the backup complete per se, but I've created the backup job. Let's see, take a look at that backup. No, let's go to backup items. You should be able to see the virtual machine backup here, which is this. As you can see, initial backup pending. Yes, the job hasn't created, which you can definitely see from here. If I should go to backup jobs, underneath backup jobs, These are the processes involved. This is for the storage. This is for the VM. It has been created for the VM. Is it 104 VM, right? So let's go ahead to the backup item. Backup item and start, because initial pending. So this is going to start at the dates and time set up in the backup policy. You need to start at the time set up for the backup policy, which is like the next day at 8 a.m. So it says 8 a.m. actually. It didn't really specify the time, but 8 a.m. and for today, 8 a.m. has passed. So the next 8 a.m. will be the next day. That's when this backup is going to start. But we can click here and backup now. We're starting the backup, retain backup till I don't really care about that because my backup policy is given as already specified what I want. So the backup job will start. It's going to take a while, but it's not going to take as long as how it would if I was creating a backup for a site. That's doing a site recovery, for setting up a site recovery in case of disaster. That one takes at least within 30 minutes. It takes like around 30 minutes to complete. For that, I might just show us how to go about starting it up. I might not wait till it completes because it's going to take within 30 minutes and I have less than 30 minutes left. So I'll just show us how to start it. Once it starts provisioning, then I'll probably stop at that point because the next thing, it's just going to finish and that's it. So let's see. We can go ahead to our backup jobs and monitor what's going on. See, as you can see, in progress. This is where you monitor the backup from. It's still in progress. Configure backup completed. This is where we started the backup. The operation is called backup. So backup is going on right now. Yeah, backup is going on right now in progress. We're just going to wait till this completes. So while this is trying to complete, because of the time, I'll just take us to our PowerPoint so we can just talk briefly about site recovery. We'll talk about site recovery, but let me see. Refresh, not yet. Okay. So I'll be sharing the PowerPoint slide again to talk about site recovery. So the site recovery helps to ensure business continuity. It makes sure there's business continuity in your organization. It does this by keeping business applications and workloads running during outages, for example, in case of disasters. So basically what it does, it replicates your workload running on physical and virtual machines from a primary site to a secondary site, which is to a different site, so that whenever an outage occurs, you can fail over to your secondary site and have access to your applications or sites, you know, until your primary site is up and running again. Then you can then fail back over to it. So basically that's what that this helps to do. It helps to meet up requirements to set up disaster recovery for your organization. It meets a requirement in case of an outage or a misconfiguration or a problem. There's some misconfiguration that turns out an app worldwide, like entirely. But if you have, probably some guys would want to go over with backup, or they would just want to, that backup would be the best scenario. But majorly in case of disaster, just in case of disasters, you need to set up site recovery, not misconfiguration. You set up site recovery. So you can replicate AWS window instances to Azure. You can replicate on-premises VMware, VMs, Hyper-V, and physical servers to secondary sites. You can replicate on-premises. You can replicate a lot. No, I'll show some other things we can replicate with we can actually replicate on Azure. I'll show that to us also. So we'll take a look at that. Then let's see. Has our backup completed? Yeah, thank God. I think we are on time. This will be the last lab, I believe. Let me share my screen, make sure the VM, the backup job is complete. Refresh just in case. Monitor, it's not complete. This is not complete yet. Nevertheless, since this is still ongoing, I'll just start up the recovery. I'll just take us to the recovery page to create a recovery, right? So this is where we'll be creating our backup job from. To create a recovery, that's for disaster recovery. Site recovery is what you click on. Click on site recovery and take a look. Things you can recover. You can have recovery, site recovery for Azure VMs, VMware machines to Azure. Then you prepare it from here. Then Hyper-V, you can do it from here. So you're replicating to another various scenarios, actually. There are various scenarios you can have. But for this, we're dealing with VMs. So I'll enable replication from here. But before that, let's check once again my backup job, if it's complete. Probably I'll refresh the entire portal to see. Okay, still not done. Yeah, it's a backup. It's going to take some time, actually. So, okay, let me go ahead to create the recovery, site recovery. To create the site recovery, click on enable replication. Click on enable replication. So, the region, the source is East US, which is where my subscription is. The source is East US. I have a subscription over there, and the source group I'm using is actually this. The source. I'll leave it at this. Do I want to select disaster recovery between availability zone? Do I want to have that? Yes or no? I can decide to. Okay, maybe I can replicate it to two different regions if I wanted. Then click on next. Or if I didn't want to do that, I could also still go ahead to select this. No. See, only virtual machines which are deployed in a zone are applicable for zone disaster. So that's explaining what that does. See, first of all, is there? Okay. Let's get back to this. I'm not done with my VM. Remember, we're not done with that. So let's make sure we conclude with that first, since I can't even proceed from here. Backup job again. Yep, still not done. So thought I'll be able to. Not be able to do my application yet, but apparently this has to complete first. So just wait a bit. Okay, while that is completing, I'll just share my screen, my slide screen. I'll just share my slide screen and demonstration Azure Backup. Yeah. Lab, I think that's it. Yeah, that's it for the class, but let's just finish up with the demo. Let this finish up first. I'll just wait a bit. Once it's complete, I would then we'll proceed from there. Let's see. we're just waiting for the other one to complete. Once it does, we'll take a look at that. So is the backup complete? No, not yet. Okay, let me share my screen and to the VM back and let's see. Okay, so back to the recovery service vault. Let's wait and see. Look at backup jobs. Still in progress. It's actually still in progress, so we'll just wait. Once this completes, we'll go ahead to create the replication and then we'll round it up from there if the time permits us to do that. So we'll just wait for this to complete. Still in progress. Okay, so probably what I'm going to do is because of the time it's taking for the backup and it's kind of using my entire time. So what I'm going to do is probably create a new VM and then replicate that VM since this one is not done yet. Let me go about doing that and do the replication from there. I'll be doing that right now in the background. So we'll take a look at that if it's complete, and then we'll proceed from there. So we can round up. It's not yet complete too. So once my new VM pops up, I'll share my screen and then we'll go ahead with the replication to round up with the class. Round up with the class and you know what, don't have much time left, but since the anair up, what I'm going to do is I'll just show us how we could go about it. So I'll just go ahead to share my screen once again. That's the lab screen, so that we can then do and round up. So I'll just go ahead and share my screen. I don't have much time anymore, so yeah. So this is the backup job I took. It's actually basically the same principle. Once that backup completed, then you start the job now, which was what I started, and it's still showing this. So it's still in progress. I can't really do much from there. Yet I think I have 4 more minutes, so I can't the VM I started hasn't completed. So what I'll do is I'll just go ahead to application and then run us quickly how it goes. So once you go to replication, enable replication. So usually as you can see, I selected my region from the source side. This is what it says. Select the location where the Azure virtual machine are currently running, which is East US, the location I created my virtual machine, right? And then, but then it says the region of the recovery services vault resource group is the same as the source region. If you are protecting across region, if you're protecting the machine across regions, across zones, you may continue for cross-regional DR. Please select a vault with its resource group and itself. in a different region. So basically, if I had, they're saying I can select a vault with its resource group and itself in a different region. I could select something different. I don't have another resource group. I don't have another vault right now created. I don't want to go ahead to. I don't have much time to go ahead to create that. So basically, what you're supposed to do, if you still want to use the same region, you can use the same region. However, then you would have to select for disaster recovery between availability zones. You would have to select yes, and then the availability zone you have to select one or two or three, whichever you prefer. For this, then you can then click on next. After which you would then see your virtual machine. You see your virtual machine over here, and then that's it. Then you click on next to go to your replication setting. Basically, there is where you create a different resource group. You create a new resource group. Create a new resource group, and probably it's to create a resource group for you. Create in a subscription resource group, in a subscription, and all that. And that's it. You've created your replication. I think I have 2 minutes left, so I don't have much time, guys. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, please, you can go ahead to ask it on the chat. I'll send over to my email or reach out to the organizer of this, and I'll go ahead to reply to your questions. Thank you very much. This is still not over. Okay, thank you very much, guys.
Wow, quite an interesting section, Paul. I learned a lot.
Sorry, stuff don't want to complete for me to.
You didn't give me time to go to application. Takes a lot of time. So
yeah. I did test before this stuff and it's finished. I don't know why now. Like it's finished like faster a lot than this. I don't know what was going on.
But notwithstanding, it's quite explicit. I mean, your explanations, everything about backups and how to create machines, phishing machines, and then coupling backups with it and resource service vaults and stuff like that.
Yeah,
thanks a lot. And yeah.
Are you still recording?
Yeah, it's recording, still going on, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay,
no problem then. I wanted to ask for your own, your own feedback, if it's okay, or feel I should have you were handled it, because I didn't get some other. I had some questions I would have loved to ask and all that too. Did he go the way you expected? Is he okay?
Come again?
Is it okay so far? Like I had questions I would have loved to ask, but so far was the way you expected?
Yeah. Okay. Thank you then. Have a nice day.
You too.
Appreciate it. Ciao. Bye.